What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. In the previous videos of the series, we covered multiple questions that may be asked during behavioral interviews. However, it was pointed to me that the answers were mostly from the point of view of an experienced software developer. So today is about fresh graduates, and if you are a fresh grad, employers will mostly be interested in understanding how you've demonstrated key competencies and skills in different contexts, mainly during school or university projects, group activities, or internships. With that said, let's go ahead and attempt to answer several questions using the STAR method as we previously did, but this time from the point of view of a fresh grad. Quick reminder before we dive in, STAR stands for Situation, Task, Action, and Result. In the situation part, we describe the context and background of the story we are telling. In the task part, we explain the specific task or challenge we were facing. In the action part, we must describe the actions took to address the situation or task while focusing on the I part of these actions. And finally, in the result, we should explain the outcome or result of these actions. Okay, let's start with the first question. Tell me about a time when you had to work on a challenging team or group project. How did you contribute to the team's success? One possible answer could be, in my final year at the university, I engaged in a challenging group project where we were assigned to develop a comprehensive inventory management system for a simulated supply chain company. The project required us to design and implement a system that could handle real-time updates of inventory levels, track product movements, and generate insightful reports for decision makers. Realizing that the project could be technically complex, I organized a team meeting to understand everyone's skills and strengths. Given my strong programming background, I volunteered to lead the backend development, which involved database management and implementing algorithms for efficient data processing. I structured the database schema to accommodate the diverse data types and relationships within the inventory system. Simultaneously, I delegated front-end development tasks based on individual expertise, ensuring a balance between user interface design and functionality. When challenges emerged, such as integrating a third-party API for real-time data updates, I took the lead in researching and implementing the solution. I collaborated with a team member who excelled in API integration, fostering a knowledge-sharing environment that contributed to the project's success. In instances of conflicting coding styles within the team, I initiated code review sessions, utilizing version control systems to manage codebase changes efficiently. Additionally, I introduced automated testing procedures to identify and address bugs early in the development cycle. Through meticulous technical planning, effective collaboration, and agile development practices, our team delivered a robust inventory management system. The application successfully met the project's requirements, demonstrated in-depth technical understanding, and showcased the seamless integration of various components. Okay, notice how the emphasis was on the individual's actions. They effectively conveyed to the interviewer their proficiency in backend development, leadership, communication, collaboration, database management, API integration, and automated testing, all within a single response. As a recent graduate, aim to highlight a diverse skill set like this when responding to questions. By showcasing a broad range of skills, you can present yourself as a well-rounded candidate capable of contributing to various aspects of a software development role. Now, another question could be, describe a situation where you faced a setback in a coding project. How did you handle it? During a coding project in my final semester, I encountered a setback when a crucial third-party library we planned to use for data encryption turned out to be incompatible with the project requirements. Our goal was to implement a secure messaging feature within a communication application, and the chosen library was central to ensuring robust data encryption. Faced with this setback, I immediately conducted a thorough analysis of alternative encryption libraries. Simultaneously, I informed the team about the issue and gathered their input on potential solutions. After researching and testing different libraries, I identified a suitable replacement that met our security requirements. To minimize the impact on the project timeline, I organized an emergency meeting where I presented my findings and explained the necessary adjustments to the codebase. Collaborating closely with the team, I took charge of modifying the codebase to integrate the new encryption library, and I documented all the changes to ensure a smooth transition. Despite the setback, our team successfully implemented the secure messaging feature using the alternative encryption library. The project was delivered on time, and we received positive feedback for adapting to changes effectively. Okay, notice how this answer was focused on ownership. It showcased the candidate's proactive approach in researching alternatives and leading the implementation of necessary adjustments. By taking ownership and successfully resolving the issue, the candidate demonstrated a commitment to the project's success and adaptability in overcoming challenges, aligning with the traits of responsibility and problem solving. Now let's try to answer one more question. Can you share a time when you had to quickly learn a new technology, skill, or programming language for a project? In a recent internship, I was assigned to a project that required expertise in a programming language and framework I hadn't previously worked with, specifically React.js for front-end development. The project involved building a dynamic dashboard for real-time data visualization, and React was deemed the most suitable technology for this task. Recognizing the urgency, I immediately dove into online tutorials, documentation, and interactive coding exercises to accelerate my learning curve in React. I organized my learning process by breaking down the framework into manageable components and understanding how they interacted. To solidify my understanding, I started a small side project to implement basic React components and gradually incorporated more advanced features. Additionally, I sought guidance from colleagues who had experience with React.js, engaging in regular knowledge-sharing sessions. Through an intensive self-learning process and collaboration with experienced colleagues, I rapidly acquired proficiency in React. Within a few weeks, I successfully integrated React.js into the project, contributing to the development of a functional and visually appealing dashboard. Okay, this response underscores the candidate's proactive approach when faced with the necessity of learning a new technology. They swiftly immersed themselves in self-directed learning, utilizing online resources and interactive exercises. The successful integration of React.js into the project not only showcased the candidate's adaptability, but also highlighted their commitment to delivering results even in unfamiliar technological domains. The answer we just gave exemplifies the candidate's ability to rapidly acquire new skills and contribute effectively to projects with diverse technical requirements. That's it! Let me know in the comments below if you'd like more videos like this one and from which point of view you'd like us to answer these questions using the STAR method. So that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.